Penguin Random House Audio presents Good Talk, a memoir in conversations. This is the author Mira Jacob with a full cast. For J and Z, you are my country. Chapter 1, 2014. The trouble began when my 6-year-old son, Z, became obsessed with Michael Jackson.
What is obsessed?
Like, into.
Really, really into?
Yes.
I'm obsessed.
6-year-old plus Michael Jackson obsession equals a lot of questions.
Who taught him to dance? What is the Jackson 5? Is that how people really walk on the moon? Is his skin like my skin? What is a LaToya? Did he lose his other glove? Is his hair like my hair?
At first, they were pretty basic.
Who is better, Michael Jackson or Michael Jordan?
That's apples and oranges.
No, Michael Jackson is a human singer, and Michael Jordan is a human...
Oh my God, stop. Michael Jackson. And then they weren't.
Was Michael Jackson brown or was he white?
Well, he was black, but his skin was brown and then it turned white.
He turned white?
Yes.
Are you going to turn white?
No.
Am I going to?
No.
Daddy?
Daddy's already white.
But was he always?
I'm East Indian and my husband is Jewish. We've lived on the same block in Brooklyn for almost 2 decades. A lot of mixed-race kids live on our block. A lot of everybody lives on our block.
Do I look like Nick?
Little. He's black and Russian.
What about Claudine?
She's Korean and Chinese.
What about the guy on the corner who is always falling asleep while he's standing?
The who? Oh, yeah. Nope, you don't look like him either.
Indians are not very cool.
That's not true. Look at Bollywood.
What?
And Mindy Kaling.
Who?
Gandhi. Gandhi is super cool.
What did he sing? Can I make my hair like Michael's?
No.
Why not?
Because that's cultural appropriation.
What?
That's using someone else's ethnicity to make a fashion statement.
What?
You'll look silly.
Oh. Okay. Mommy, I have changed my name to the 6th Jackson.
Wait, really? I'm supposed to say, this is my son, the 6th Jackson?
No, just say, this is the 6th Jackson. And then I will show them my moves and then they will understand.
Damn. And now, time for new color theory with even more 6-year-old.
When I'm with you, people think I look like you. And when I'm with Daddy, people think I look like him. Except in the summer, because that's when I am super deluxe extra brown. And Daddy isn't, because maybe he drank too much milk when he was little. So I should probably only ever drink chocolate milk, so I can look like Michael Jackson, right?
Nice try.
What did Michael Jackson like being better? Brown or white?
He liked both.
But what did he like better?
Neither.
But what...
Can we please stop talking about this?
What color was he when he sang Man in the Mirror? I'm going to turn myself white.
No, you cannot decide to be white. It doesn't work like that.
And I will have red lips, and my nose will look like it's falling off, and I will scare kids even though I love them.
Nope. Every time Z asked me a question, I would remember all the times I had asked similar questions growing up. All the things I had been told. All the things that still didn't make sense.
But why?
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 Why? Why?
Why?
In August, an unarmed teenager named Michael Brown was shot and killed by a Missouri cop. By fall, protests against police brutality were shutting down the streets of New York. Whose streets?
Whose streets? Is it bad to be brown?
What? No, it's great being brown. We look good in colors. We have history. We don't get skin cancer as easily.
Why are you yelling at me?
I don't know.
The TV said the police killed a kid named Ferguson because he was brown.
His name was Michael Brown. He was black. He was killed in a town called Ferguson.
By a white police?
Policeman. Yes.
Ferguson is far away, right? Are white people afraid of brown people?
Sometimes.
How do you know?
What?
How do you know which ones are afraid of you? Mommy, how do you—
You don't always.
Is Daddy afraid of us?
No. No. That night, in bed, I told Jed.
Wait, he asked you that? If I was afraid of him?
So I told him no, and that sometimes the news is hard to understand, and—
Our son?
What?
Our son asked if I was afraid of him?
Yes.
What do we do?
I don't know. Sometimes, you don't know how confused you are about something important until you try explaining it to someone else. For years, I had been telling myself that America was changing for the better, and that the pain and confusion I'd felt growing up here would soon be a thing of the past. Hadn't we just elected our first black president? Didn't that mean those of us who'd always been treated like we were suspicious or invisible or just lucky to be allowed in were finally going to feel like we were safe and welcome and loved? Now, every question Z asked made me realize the growing gap between the America I'd been raised to believe in and the one rising fast all around us. I kept thinking, if I could go back in time and make sense of the things I'd been told growing up, I would be able to give Z better answers. Maybe even find a way toward that better country. Soon, though, with the news of the Black Lives Matter movement flooding our televisions and the rise of Donald Trump, I would have just as many questions as he did. Chapter 2. Indians in America. No matter how many times I heard about how my parents met and married, it didn't make sense.
I met your father in January 1968. We married in Bombay the next month. We arrived in America at the end of March.
Just like that?
What just like that? That's how everyone did it.
My father was always a little better with the details.
I wanted to come to America to study open-heart surgery, but my mother said she wouldn't let me go unless I married someone from home. So I looked through a stack of pictures and said, her and no one else.
Why her?
Have you seen that picture?
That picture. My mother said,
I came home from college one day and my parents said, Daddy's job has been transferred to Italy. We are moving. You are not coming with us. You will get married. We went and had this picture taken and sent it out.
My grandmother's version of the story.
We didn't want her in the dangerous hands of Italian men.
Wikipedia will tell you Christianity came to India in the 2nd or 3rd century. Most Westerners assume it came with British colonization.
It most certainly did not.
My parents are Syrian Christian. Syrian Christians will tell you Christianity came to India around 52 AD with the arrival of St. Thomas. To find a match for my mother, her parents put the word out among their community, and several young men, including my father, came to meet her. So your parents decided?
Of course not. It was my choice. But those other boys were so silly, sitting around all day drinking Campa Cola. Here was your father, with his big dream of becoming a surgeon. He was going to America. I thought, what an adventure.
Wow!
What can I say? I was young and dumb.
Here is the thing. Usually, all the parents will leave, so the two will have a little time to talk alone. But when we met, our parents wouldn't leave the room. Afterward, outside, I yelled. I said, "Who is getting married? You or me?" My mother said, "If you marry her, you will have plenty of time to talk alone."
All of your parenting skills suddenly make sense. So when did you and Mom talk for the first time?
After we married.
You've got to be kidding.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.